It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10, listening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow.
Oh, I do not remember telling Ivan to make a gingerbread house.
You didn't, because I made it.
Oh, Erica, you know that I love you, but your lattes taste like dear old battery acid. Food just isn't your forte, so can we just put this maybe in the back? Wow, that tastes like... like Christmas and Rudolph and a gingerbread latte exploded in my mouth all at once.
You gonna be nicer now?
I'm so sorry, chicken. And it's this time of year. It brings out my mother in me. Now, the 50-50 Press holiday soiree is way inclusive. So for our guests observing Kwanzaa, we have a Unity Cup and a Makika.
Oh, cool.
And next for you and your peeps, Erica, a menorah.
Oh, technically it's a Hanukkah, but thank you very much. That's a very sweet gesture.
Oh, well, it's not just a gesture. Hanukkah's a major holiday.
Actually, Yom Kippur is major, Rosh Hashanah is major, but Hanukkah, it's not so major.
Oh, hold on to your tinsel, ladies. Jolly old Saint Ivan is in the house.
You look amazing.
He knows. He's been staring in a mirror for 3 hours.
Oh.
Dave, that throne is gorgeous. This party is gonna rock.
It's gonna jingle bell rock.
Well, it better, because I'm keeping a list and I'm checking it twice. And if anything that is on here is not out there, I'm gonna be dropping 2 lumps of coal down your bear cave chimney.
Oh. Make sure to answer with a hello. Oh.
Hello. Oh.
Erica?
Hey, Dad.
When are you going to be here? We'll hold off lighting the candles.
No, wait. I have the 50-50 holiday work party tonight. Didn't Mom tell you?
No, your mother didn't tell me.
No, Lennon, just one for the first night.
Oh. Sorry, first Hanukkah.
You're not going to be here for the first night of Hanukkah. You know it's a family tradition, Erica.
I know, Dad, but I have the work party, so...
Why don't I come over to your place another night?
Dad, don't make me feel bad.
I'm sorry. It's okay, honey. Go and enjoy your party.
Okay, well, I'll swing by tomorrow. Hug Samaya.
Happy Hanukkah to you, too.
Ho, ho, ho.
Hey. Wow, look at this place. You really need more decorations.
I'll take those. Okay, this is not holly. This is cedar.
I'm aware, Julianne, but they ran out of holly. I apologize.
Thank you.
Thanks. Julianne is in full-on stress mode.
Julianne and everyone else are there on the roads and the shops, stores. I mean, it's just one other day of the year.
No holiday Scroogey Grinch talk, mister. I am determined to make this a good Christmas for you.
Erica, you have enough on your plate already. You know, with this work shindig tonight and family commitments, don't add me to your list of obligations.
Oh, well, you're already number one on it, so. I know that the holidays, they make you sad. And I don't want you to be. I just want to make you happy. Starting with...
Okay, well, that's a good start.
same mincemeat.
You're going tubing on Christmas Day?
If Santa over there can get over his acrophobia, yeah. But if not, we'll just go cross-country skiing like always.
With all of your parents? That, I mean, that's so cute.
They kind of live for it. It's pretty adorable.
Okay, I live for Christmas, too, inside, where it's warm. With my mom's homemade Christmas quilts, loads of presents and carols and crackers and all the other Giacomelli traditions.
You have everything but chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
No, we usually have those too. And Adam, what about you? Any special Christmas traditions you're going to share with Erica this year?
My family likes to get drunk and pass out in the Christmas pudding. I can't. Rum and eggnog, anyone? No?
Yeah.
Either this tapenade tastes like leather or I just put a size 6 Santa boot right in my mouth.
No, it's, you know what, it's not you. Adam, he just has bad family memories of the holidays.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to dredge up the ghosts of Christmas past. I know.
I don't know what to do for him. You know, I've seen all the Christmas movies, and I think I know what it's supposed to be like. And this is going to sound cheesy, but I want that for him.
Okay, I think that's beautiful.
Are you crying?
Okay, yes, because I'm a sap, and I just love this time of year. It just brings out the best in people. And I have to say, when it comes to perfect Christmases, I'm kind of an expert.
Well, good then, because I'm not. Maybe you could help me. You could be, like, my Christmas coach.
Oh, I'd love to. So it starts with a present. You have to pick something that is very important to both of you.
Santa, baby, just slip a sable under the tree.
There you go. Okay, thank you very much.
I've been awful busy. Says a baby, I hurry down the chimney.
Oh, excuse me. Hey. Oh, my God. This is a great party.
Thanks. Look, we have cider, we have hot cocoa, and if you want something more alcoholic, we have rum and eggnog.
Well, no, thanks. I'm just going to get a cider. Do you want one?
No, I'm okay.
Judith.
Chris, I'm going to catch up with you in just a bit.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi, honey.
Another one you get a chance to pick up.
That doesn't look like a rum and eggnog.
No, that's because it's an Irish car bomb. Just doing my bit to help the Irish economy.
Oh. Well, I got you a Christmas present.
Erica.
No, I know that you said not to, but look, it's very small.
A door.
Get it? From therapy.
Get it.
I stole it from the gingerbread house. I hope no one notices.
Thank you.
Okay, next up, picture with Santa.
Erica. The door is great, but really, I'm not up for this Christmas stuff.
Oh, come on. One picture to remember tonight by. Just you and me and jolly old Saint Nick.
Ho, ho, ho. Come, young lady, and sit on Santa's lap. You too, young man.
Everybody say Gouda on three. One, two, three.
Gouda!
All right. Ooh, wait, Adam. Let's try it again. This time, think of, like, sugar plum berries.
It's
sorry. Adam. Hey. You're not gonna have fun if you don't even try.
I told you, Christmas is just not my thing.
I know, Adam. I'm just trying to make you happy because I know that this time of year is hard for you because of your family.
Erica, I didn't ask you to make this time of year fun for me because there's no way it can be, okay? I'm sorry, just need some air. Excuse me.
Adam. Adam, wait.
Happy holidays, Erica. Would you mind handing me that silver bell?
Look, I hope you didn't call me in here to help you decorate your Christmas tree, because I'm not really an expert.
Well, then perhaps you wouldn't mind assisting me with this.
Why do you have a Hanukkah?
Traditions all over the world celebrate a winter holiday, so I choose to observe them all.
You must be really busy right now.
You have no idea. Would you do me the honor of lighting the first candle?
Mm-hmm.
This is the first night of Hanukkah, after all. For 8 days, they celebrated. Maccabees.
Do the Maccabees have any advice about how to patch things up with Adam?
Well, what happened?
Well, it's just, you know, Christmas, it's a difficult time of year for him. You know his family. And I just hope that I could reboot the holidays for him this year.
Because you feel he's been missing out.
Well, of course he has. You know, he never had a Christmas tree growing up. No presents, no stockings, and I know that he's not a child anymore, but...
What?
No, being Jewish this time of year, especially when you're a kid, it's really hard. You know, everywhere there's this crazy, shiny, amazing party, and you're not invited. So it must be doubly hard if you are invited to the party, but nobody cares enough to throw the party for you.
So if you could give Adam a real Christmas, one with lots of presents and boughs of holly and carols sung by a roaring fire, you think that that would help him?
I think that it would help him look at the holidays in a new light. Just... I think that it would make him happy.
Or you might be missing the forest for the Christmas trees.
What does that mean? Christmas zit? Gasp.
Sorry?
You should be. It's 7 o'clock, Julian. Only idiots and preschoolers are up. Go back to bed. It's just like a stocking from a magazine. What?
That's because it is a stocking from a magazine. Your real one's under the tree. Remember, Sleepyhead?
Oh. Totally makes sense. Two stockings.
It makes sense to your mother. That's all that matters, Chicken.
Chicken. So... weird.
You want some advice, honey?
Okay.
Go get dressed for the big portrait before you get us both in trouble. And then we open stuff, okay?
Oh, okay.
That one's mine.
Oh, right, sorry.
Merry Christmas.
me check and see if that wound correctly.
Well, the flash went off, honey.
Oh, Juliana, don't move. I want one more picture, just to be safe.
Oh, sorry. Annual photo op is a deadly serious matter.
Which is why you chose to dress as a witch this year. Okay, now, all together, everyone. Eyes open and...
Fruitcake!
Ah, perfect. Thank you.
Now,
we open presents and panettone, your favorite.
Oh, good, I'm starved. Wait! Don't move! Is that star crooked?
It looks fine to me, honey.
It's crooked, Remo.
Oh, star of wonder, star of light. Fix the star or have a fight.
Does that mean we're doing it again?
Yes, that means we're going again. Laugh at me now, but one day you're going to be glad to have all these nice pictures.
Fruitcake.
Perfect.
Do we get to open the presents now? Please?
Yes.
What is with you today? You're acting like you're 8 years old.
I thought everybody was excited at Christmas.
Your sister loves this time of year. Now, why is that a bad thing?
I don't know, because maybe she doesn't even see that she's part of this giant consumerist culture that is so hypocritical.
Consumerist? That's a big word.
Have you read Chomsky?
Yes.
Liar. You're not even a kid, and you still listen to New Kids on the Block.
Excuse me, Georgie, but reading Chomsky and listening to New Kids are not mutually exclusive.
You don't even understand what I'm talking about.
Girls, 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 it's Christmas morning. Please stop fighting. Have some panettone, some eggnog, and then we will open presents.
Your Nona sent that all the way from Italy. Just for you, Julianne, because it's your favorite.
Wow. Whoa. Maybe I just need to wash it down. Oh, wow.
Oh,
freak.
Everyone, I've never opened this many gifts in my entire life.
Wait, I think Santa missed something over here. Let's see. Oh, for Georgie.
Hey, who's that one from?
Oh, that's for me. I hope you like it.
Tolerance. You got me a rock.
Maybe you should tell your sister what you were thinking when you bought it.
Well, tolerance, it's a beautiful concept, especially at this time of the year.
And I need to be reminded of that. Why? Because I'm intolerant?
Come on. Your sister wouldn't be trying to hurt your feelings at Christmas.
Wouldn't she?
Well, I have to agree. It isn't the most thoughtful gift.
Honey, not helping.
I mean, it isn't quite as thoughtless as an electric grill. Hey, are there any other presents under here, maybe?
Are you calling my gift thoughtless? Do you know how long I had to spend on the phone to get you one of those? They're the biggest gift of the season.
Oh, yeah, Mom, they're great. Trust me, it's like, you know, it's like having a barbecue in your kitchen.
Oh, well, that's just wonderful. So I can use my gift to barbecue for all of you.
No, Mom,
No, you know what? It's fine. I do all the work around here, making sure your Christmases are something to remember. I'm the big joke, and I'm the cook and the maid.
And clearly, I'm the worst husband in the world. Cassandra, how many times have you told me that you wished you had a grill? So I got you a grill.
I didn't want it for Christmas.
Dad, be careful. You're sounding intolerant. Wouldn't want Julianne getting you one of these for Father's Day.
Georgie, hey, look, I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking. Give me the rock and I'll take it back to the store.
Oh, no, this is mine now.
No, Georgie, you hate it. Come on, give it to me.
No, it's useful. It reminds me what kind of sister I have.
No, come on.
Merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay.
Yeah. Dismay, that about sums it up.
Well, that's hardly in the spirit of the season. Well, you didn't get enough presents?
No, I got loads, but the tension around it all, it was unbelievable. It just feels like there's way too many expectations for one morning.
Well, you thought that it would be all candy canes and chestnuts roasting on an open fire and five golden rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves.
Dr. Tom.
Almost. And a partridge in a pear tree. Go ahead.
Yes, that's what I thought, but it's through no fault of my own. I mean, Julianne, she swears up and down that Christmas, it's the best time of year.
Well, what do you think?
Well, I'm sure not feeling the Christmas spirit that she's talking about. And clearly, she and Georgie, they hate each other. Cassandra, she's seriously type A. And I was feeling bad for Ramo until the whole grill incident. You know what? Adam, he may be a Grinch during Christmas, but at least he's honest about it.
Christmas is a time when you get homesick, even when you're home. Carol Nelson.
Julianne!
Yeah?
Who is at the door?
Just a caroler.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Why, thank you, madam. God bless us, everyone.
Huh. Julianne, put your coat on. We can't be late for mass.
She's stalling because she's nervous.
Nervous? For what? We're just going to church. It's not like I have to...
Get up there and do a solo?
A solo?
If I have to listen to you sing Silent Night one more time, I will barf.
Oh, no, wait, I'm singing in front of, like, a church full of people. Have you guys heard my voice? Father Angelo says you sound terrific.
I hope so, after all the lessons we paid for.
Oh, Mom, Dad.
Okay, come on, let's go. Parking's gonna be a nightmare. Julianne, put your coat on.
Come on, Jake.
Now is the day of joy. Let us not revenge. Now is the day of goodwill. Let us not be cruel.
Georgie.
Today,
Georgie.
Divine being.
Take
upon
the two to Silent Night. Yes.
The seal
take
of our humanity.
With what?
Girls.
Of divinity.
We're in church.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And also, yeah. With you.
And now, dear friends, a Christmas gift for us all. The God-given voice of Julianne Giacomelli. Julianne.
Go, honey. Merry Christmas. Sorry, I don't know what's wrong with me.
Awful, right?
It was nice to see Georgie sing.
Actually, it was pretty great seeing the two of you sing together again. It's been a long time. Now, would anybody like a nice light lunch? Nothing to spoil your dinner.
Let me get that, Cass. You just sit and relax.
Oh. Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Put so much effort into making Christmas perfect for us. It's your turn to enjoy yourself. How does grilled cheese and salumi sound?
It sounds great. I guess I'll rustle up some coffee. And don't worry, Julianne, I will make you a latte.
Thanks, Mom. And thank you for coming to my rescue.
Yeah, well, it was too much watching you die up there. Even for me.
Look, about the present I got you.
Don't worry about it.
No, really, I didn't get it to hurt you. You know, that's not Julianne's. That's not my style. I think that we're so different, and I see you in... You're all intellectual and political, and I think that I kind of wanted to get you something deep. And I picked the wrong thing.
Yeah, well, tolerance is a really deep message.
Yeah, it is. And it's pretty perfect for the season.
We are different. But maybe I could be more tolerant of everything that makes you, well, you.
That was one crazy Christmas morning, huh?
Yeah. Crazy.
What are you talking about? That was nothing.
Nothing? The tree fell over.
Sorry about that. Again.
That's right. It's like this every year. Remember 2 years ago when you killed the oven and we had to have Chinese food?
Really?
Or the year before that, Winona was here and he flooded the upstairs bathroom?
That's right, and it came through the ceiling and went on the tree and ruined the presents.
Anyway, here's to another crazy Giacomelli Christmas.
Here, here, here.
Oh my God.
Celebrate Christmas.
But I want a candy cane and a picture to show my friends.
Sam, we've got to get home to set up for the party. Why don't I buy you a lollipop for the car?
I don't want a lollipop. I want a candy cane. I'll be so fast. Look, there's no lineup. Please.
Okay, Samantha Rachel Strange, keep your voice down.
Mom, just let her. Santa isn't even a Christian icon. If anything, he's pagan.
Erica, please don't cause problems for me right now. I got a lot to deal with.
I'm just saying that you're making way too big a deal of this. One candy cane from Santa Claus isn't going to make Sam convert.
Just this one time, Mommy. Please let me.
Okay. Go.
Thank you, Mommy.
Pagan, when did you get so smart?
You ready? Smile.
Hey, honey.
Whoop-la.
Look what I've got.
So, you visited Santa.
I asked for a talking cabbage patch doll.
And Transformers for me and Leo. She's that generous.
Thanks, Sam, but I wouldn't count on Santa delivering to this house.
Leo.
What are you doing?
Wishing you a happy Hanukkah.
Okay, thanks. You want to let go?
Leo, can you put these bags in the kitchen for me, please?
Okay, Mom.
Daddy, did you know Santa has 12 reindeer and elves who make all the presents?
Really? Barb, can we speak for a moment?
Of course. Erica, can you get the rest of the bags from the car, please?
Sure.
Thanks. So, what's going on?
Memories of Hanukkah's past.
Okay, you sent me back to experience Christmas so that I could learn that it's not all snowflakes and reindeers, and now I'm doing Hanukkah in the 80s?
Well, not just any Hanukkah. I mean, this one was particularly memorable.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I was, like, 11?
It'll come back to you. Forgive me, it's just the irony of it all. I mean, here you are, you know, wanting to give Adam the perfect Christmas.
Yes, and?
This is funny. The apple never falls far from the tree.
Still in the dark here.
Well, thank you, Erica. You go off and enjoy some Hanukkah magic, and I promise that all will be revealed.
Too bad. They're Jewish. They have to deal with it.
You're overreacting.
Where's this gonna end up, Barb? We're gonna get a Christmas tree in here, put up light, blah, 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 blah.
She sat on Santa's lap and took a picture. You know, you're blowing this out of proportion.
How am I such a bad?
Erica? Did I do something bad?
Oh, no, no. Don't worry about it, okay? Everything's gonna be all right.
Start.
Okay.
Oh, could have fooled me, hon.
No, I didn't fool you. I'm just stating something.
Hey, anyone up for a little dreidel spinning?
Well, thanks, Uncle Joe.
Erica, if I were older, do you think George Michael would like me?
I don't think you're his type, Sam.
What was that?
That was a very special visitor to our house, who we are welcoming this year.
Did that come from the roof?
It did indeed. Say hello to Judah the Lion.
Judah the Lion.
He's a reincarnation of
Judah the Maccabee. I remember this. If you burn your wishes over the Hanukkah and scatter the ashes, Judah magically reassembles them and brings you presents.
Were you eavesdropping?
Maybe.
Hold it. Are you saying there's a lion on our roof right now, Daddy?
Yes, sweetie. I think so. If we listen carefully, we might hear him.
Ooh. All right, exciting. I'll be in my room listening to the Smiths. Call me when it's time to eat.
Oh, no. You've got to write your wishes down for Judah. Otherwise, you might not get anything for Hanukkah.
Come on, Dad, seriously.
What can it hurt? Besides, you might have some fun. Judah the Maccabee was a fierce warrior who stormed the temple. And with a few men, he defeated the mighty Assyrian army.
So when did he become a lion, Daddy?
I'm getting to that, sweetie. Judah the Maccabee lived for many years.
And then he died and became a lion who loves rooftops. Can I go now?
Leo.
What? This is whack.
It's Hanukkah, and I'm trying to tell a story.
Yeah, well, I learned the real story in Hebrew school. What you're telling us is a lie.
Leo, if you want to go to your room, go.
Barb! I want the family together, and that includes our son.
I'm not pretending to believe in a fake lion, okay?
Dad, Judah the Lion is fake?
Not exactly, sweetheart.
He's pretend.
I don't know why I even bother.
You girls want to help me make latkes?
Okay. I'll be right back.
Potatoes?
Hey, Dad.
I just wanted to give you kids something to enjoy, to be excited about. I wanted to make it special for you.
We have Hanukkah traditions. Yeah, they're a little lame, but so what?
So what? So, Christmas is everywhere, but we're Jews. And I don't want my family, my children, growing up feeling like there's something out there that's better than what we've got here.
But Christmas isn't about the tree, or the holly, or the tinsel of the gifts, because even you have all of that stuff, it means nothing if you're not together, as a family. We have that, Dad. We are together. And that's what it's all about.
You've got your mother's brains.
Thanks. I just hope I have some of your heart.
So, are you still in the dark?
No. No. It's not about trying to give Adam the perfect Christmas, because there is no such thing, first of all. And second of all, I think that I was missing the point.
Which is?
That the holidays, they're all about being with the people you love.
Yeah, which is why you and Julianne are so fortunate. You know, you both have families who love you.
Yeah. And Adam doesn't.
Erica, he can't see you.
What is he doing here?
Well, this is last Christmas. And here is where he spent it.
I mean, I know that Adam is estranged from his family, but surely he has friends that he spent the holidays with.
If you count whiskey as a friend, Adam does.
Hey, Bobby. Another whiskey when you get a chance. Coming right up.
You know, if it was me, I would just stay at home and I'd draw the blinds and grab some Chunky Monkey and watch TV.
There is a comfort of being amongst people like yourself. You know, my first Christmas, after Sarah left, I spent in a place much like this. You know, Adam is here because today, more than any other, he is seeking something that he truly needs.
And what he doesn't need. Which is apparently me dragging around to sit on Santa's lap. Ugh.
Cheers, Bobby.
Giuseppe Mazzini said that family is the country of the heart. You know, we spend so much of our lives in exile. But on the holidays, we make the pilgrimage home to the nation of our heart, wherever that may be.
Buddy. Do you want to hear a knock-knock joke? Sure. I'll warn you in advance. It's pretty terrible.
Okay.
Knock-knock.
Unless you're like Adam. And you don't have a family to go home to.
That's right. Is there such a thing as the perfect holiday? I think that question kind of misses the point, really.
Because all holidays are about the same thing.
And what's that?
Connecting to the people that care about you. Feeling like you're a part of something. Family, a community, a culture. Thanks, Dr. Tom.
Chag Sameach, Erica.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, Julianne, have you seen Adam?
Chicken, I think he's already left. I'm sorry.
Yeah, but I'm like a bad box of fruitcake. I just keep coming back.
Excuse me. I have to do a repair on that gingerbread house. Would you believe some party pooper swiped the door?
Ow!
I'm sorry.
No, I am.
No, I am.
Don't fight about it.
Listen, it was wrong of me to cram Christmas down your throat. You should do whatever you need to do in order to feel okay for the holidays. Just no pressure.
Thanks.
I have to split soon to go to my parents' Hanukkah party.
I thought you weren't going.
Changed my mind. And I would love for you to come. I mean, it's going to be filled with crazy people and games that probably make no sense and oily food.
This is your sales pitch.
And if you don't want to go, it's totally cool, Adam. It's like I said, there's just no pressure.
Would you look at that?
One Christmas tradition I can get behind.
Oh, well then, you know, far be it for me. On that note, I think that we should run before we miss the candle lighting.
You can't come to the candles come to you.
Dad, what?
Hi, honey.
What are you guys doing here?
It wasn't a Hanukkah party without you.
So we thought we'd crash.
With latkes and applesauce,
Mom. I ate the last donut on the way over. You gotta love a holiday that comes with donuts.
I don't care where I light the Hanukkah, Erica. As long as I do it with my family.
Come in. Yes, absolutely. Okay. Julianne, strangers are here.
Right my
here.
Favorite. Welcome.
How are you, Mom?
Hi, Julianne.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lake, snow is glistening. Happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird. Here to stay is the new bird. Unafraid, those plans that we made, walking in.